Hi, this is Frank Taylor with Nature at Your Door, and today I'm not outside my door, but I'm inside my door to discuss the Asian lady beetle and the fact that I found out that it can bite. I did an extensive video on the biology and history of Asian lady beetles, how they got here, what they're doing in your house, why they're there. And I inadvertently said that they were harmless, that they didn't bite. Well, I got corrected by so many of my viewers that I had to follow up this research. I've never been bitten by them, and neither has my wife, but they do bite. And I wanted to find out why, because it really made no sense to me. There's no reason for them to do it. So today's episode is about the Asian lady beetle, how to identify it, and how it's different from our native lady beetle, and why they bite, and how they do it, and do you need to worry about being bitten by them? So stay tuned. Right here in your backyard, you never know what you're gonna find. In the United States, we have 24 species of ladybugs. Ladybugs are actually beetles, and they feed primarily on soft-bodied aphids that damage many of our crops and our garden plants. There are a few species of ladybugs that feed on plants, but most of the species are carnivores. And thus, being carnivores, they have jaws designed for capturing and eating other organisms. Aphids are the favorite food of ladybugs, and a ladybug can eat up to 5,000 aphids in a lifetime. So we consider ladybugs beneficial insects. So being primarily predators, they do come equipped with jaws. And so theoretically, an organism with jaws has the potential to be able to bite human beings. Many of us older folks like me have grown up with ladybugs, and we're always fascinated and happy to see one. If a ladybug inadvertently landed on you, it was considered good luck. And there's many stories and folklore and children's books about ladybugs. This bright colored red with black dots organism was endeared by so many and captured in stories and children's books. Many people even purchase ladybugs to release in their gardens as a deterrent to the aphids that were damaging their plants. However, many people bought Asian lady beetles to release in their gardens, and this wasn't a good thing. The Asian lady beetles, as you know, if you have hundreds of these in your house, are very invasive. And the bad thing is too, is they're out competing our native lady beetles that we love and of lore and of books and stories. Our native ladybug populations are dropping in part due to pesticide overuse, as well as the competition with these very aggressive Asian ladybugs. You can tell the difference between a native ladybug and an Asian ladybug by a couple of characteristics. Number one, if you can look at them closely, look at the pronotum. The pronotum on our native lady beetles is black and has a white spot on both sides, like this one pictured here. The Asian lady beetle has an M on the pronotum, and that M can vary in its intensity and pattern, but it's always there. Look for that M. If you see the M, it's an Asian lady beetle. Also, Asian lady beetles are the only ones that find in large groups. If you see large groups of them, you got Asian lady beetles. And the last thing is Asian lady beetles, as the name implies, multicolored Asian lady beetles, come in many, many different colors and many different numbers of spots and many different patterns. So if you see large groups of ladybugs with multiple colors, you know you got Asian ladybugs. So I had many viewers watch my Asian ladybug video and then write in and say, "Hey, Frank, you said they were harmless. You said they don't bite." Well, they do in fact bite. So I incorrectly when during my research, I think talked about the native ladybug, which is really, really rare to bite and really low in number. So the chance of being bitten by a native ladybug was extremely low. But when you have hundreds of Asian ladybugs and in somewhat duress, then the chances go up greatly. My wife and I have had hundreds of ladybugs come out, usually in the springtime, where they come out of the woodwork here and the stonework that I have. So they have lots of hiding places. And when the weather warms up in the spring is when we see the greatest numbers. I've vacuumed hundreds a day for several weeks before the onslaught is over. And in all that time, my wife and I have never been bitten by Asian lady beetles. So I was like really curious, why are these beetles biting people? What is going on here? What would be the purpose of that? So this is what I found out. So unlike mosquitoes or bed bugs or horseflies or kissing bugs, all those bugs bite humans purposely for the reason of getting a blood meal to get protein to lay eggs. But ladybugs, they feed on aphids or on plants. Why would they bite humans? It just didn't make sense to me. And as I did further research, there was still some skepticism in the writings of entomologists about whether ladybugs bite and how bad the bites are. I think though they were still focusing on our native species. And again, the Asian ladybug is a different animal altogether. So the Asian lady beetle does absolutely bite, and the sensitivity may vary greatly from person to person, depending on, well, kind of the thickness of their skin and the person's biochemistry and reaction to the bite. Asian lady beetles occurring in large numbers in new environments are opportunists and will fight for survival. If there's a drop in their food sources, or if they're risking dehydration and a drought, they're going to look to alternative sources of both energy and moisture in order to survive. In England, the newspapers have twice reported cases during a low population time of aphids and another time during a drought where the number of bites on humans increased dramatically as they sought nutrition or moisture. There is some research that even indicated that the Asian ladybugs might be landing on your skin and biting as a source of salt. So Asian ladybugs, being opportunists, when pressed for resources, are going to try and investigate other sources of nutrition and water. So that brings us to these Asian ladybugs in your home. Really, the inside environment of your home is not ideal place for Asian ladybugs to overwinter. It's really too warm and too dry. So their metabolism will increase, their need for moisture will increase. And so I think these Asian ladybugs occurring in large numbers in your house are going to start to fight for survival. These bugs in your house may be more likely to bite you in the winter time when their food sources and moisture sources are low. In my house, but my wife and I have never been bitten. And I'm thinking that perhaps it's because they're able to gain moisture from condensation on our windows. So researchers still categorize ladybugs, including Asian ladybugs, as harmless because while they have jaws, they're really very small. They don't generally, if ever, draw blood, and I'm sure there's going to be exceptions to this rule. They don't inject you with anything. They don't carry diseases. And when they bite, it's really more scraping of the surface of your skin. A problem comes in with certain individuals who are allergic to things from the ladybug. For example, people we know can be allergic to pollen, people can be allergic to peanut butter, people can have various kinds of food allergies. Well, people can be allergic to ladybugs, their bites, and also the proteins are released when they do that protective bleeding from the joints, which releases that foul-smelling substance to avoid predation. So if you could possibly be very allergic to them, just as some people are very allergic to bee stings. So that's where we have to draw the line. And that's where almost anything that is technically classified as harmless can become harmful depending on the individual and their particular biochemistry. So I want you to know, I'm not going to try to compete with Coyote Peterson and go around and have lots of different organisms bite me and sting me on camera. But I had so many viewers write to me about this phenomena of Asian ladybugs biting them. I felt like I owed it to them to try it and see if I could get them to bite me. Well, I tried putting them on my hands. I handled them. I let them walk over me. My wife did the same thing while I was filming. They walked over her hands and up her arm. I put some inside this shot glass and held them against my arm for 5-10 minutes, no bites. I tried kind of squeezing them between my fingers, not so much that it would hurt them, but to try to make them panic and get them to bite me, and they just wouldn't bite me despite everything I did. So the fact is, Asian lady beetles, and it's been documented both by my viewers and outside researchers, the Asian beetles do bite and far more likely to bite than our native ones. And also, since there's so many more, there's more opportunity and more likely for it to happen. Thank you for watching this episode of Nature at Your Door. Hope you learned some new things. I've learned a lot getting ready for and researching this particular episode. If you like what I do, please give me a like and subscribe to my channel. And I look forward to hearing comments from you. I love answering questions from my viewers. But thanks again for watching this episode of Nature at Your Door. And I'll see you next time.